Bring the good old bugle, boys, we'll sing another song. Sing it with the spirit that will start the world along. Sing it as we used to sing it 50,000 strong. While we were marching through Georgia. Hurrah, hurrah, we bring the jubilee. Hurrah, hurrah, the flag that makes you free. So we sang a chorus from Atlanta to the sea. While we were marching through Georgia. So we made a thoroughfare for freedom and her train. 60 miles in latitude, 300 to the main. She's been before us, for resistance was in vain. While we were marching through Georgia. Hurrah, hurrah, we bring the jubilee. Hurrah, hurrah, the flag that makes you free. So we sang a chorus from Atlanta to the sea. While we were marching through Georgia.
Yeah, this may work for a while. So we just got back from Charleston, South Carolina, where we were invited by the National Park Service to perform at Fort Sumter, which is, of course, where the Civil War really began. Thank you. It was fun. But that song that we just did, we got a call from the head ranger and said, please don't play that song when you come to South Carolina. And if you know the lyrics to that song, that was basically how the Union kind of tromped their way through Georgia and burned and pillaged, and they said, we don't want any part of that. They also said, please don't play Dixie, which kind of surprised us. And then Battle Hymn of the Republic, which at the time was really a Union sympathizer lyric. But the trip was just fantastic. We did three sets at the fort. We played on the hangar deck of the Yorktown, which is a CV-class aircraft carrier that's in the harbor there in Charleston, and at White's Point in the gazebo there that almost dates back. And we got a little joy out of the fact that there's a big sign out front that says dedicated by the Daughters of the Confederate. And you go, okay, so anyway, you get it. So this next song is a medley of kind of Civil War tunes, just a little something to kind of get you all in the mood. This is broadly called Sicilian Circle, but it's a medley of two very, very popular tunes during this period.
Thank you.
there were many traditions that started, well, we were a new country. We didn't have many traditions. We hadn't been around long enough to have that stuff yet. But one of the musical traditions that really started in the American Civil War was it was the first time where military units commissioned a march or a hymn or a song that would be uniquely theirs, something that would identify them, their unit, their service, their pride, their esprit de corps. In the modern day manifestation of that, if you've had service in any of our major military branches, Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, CBs, Girl Scouts, who else am I forgetting? Yeah. They've all got their own song. And when you hear your song, and if you've had service in any of those organizations, you'll stand out of a sense of pride, not so much for the song itself, but really for what it represents. And this next song is an early song of that tradition. This was commissioned by the New York Light Guard. The New York Light Guard was a mounted light cavalry in New York. And they commissioned this song because they were very proud of the fact that as a mounted unit, they wanted something that would depict almost the prancing of the hoofs and the whole rhythmic kind of thing that goes along. It's really not quite what he had in mind in the march. But as you hear this march, you'll kind of hear that idea of horses. And at the very end, you can hear the horn call, kind of an homage to the British, where they would release the hounds, and they would hunt the fox, and they would call the hounds back with a little horn call. So you can hear it at the very end. So this is the New York Light Guard Quick Step. So American music, we always think about American music, and then when we stop and kind of back into that a little bit, it's like, what really is that? And it's this remarkable amalgam of music that came from all parts of the world during this amazing period of immigration when people all came to America to be part of this great experiment called America. And they brought with them so many traditions, their clothing and their art, and in many cases their music, their food, and although the slaves came not because they felt like they were looking for a new chance. They were here because they had no choice. And their music was so much in a part of our traditional music and really about the roots of jazz. Spirituals were primarily sung by slaves in the early part of our nation's history. And it was a way for them to just sing and sing in praise and to also express the grief and sorrow that they were going through. This next song is one of those spirituals that seems to have found its way into the more common American nomenclature. And we'd like to feature now our principal bass drummer, because she really has other talent than that. And this is Miss Vicki Gordon singing Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. Victoria Gordon. Thank you. We're available for weddings and bar mitzvahs. Actually, we're doing a wedding. This is absolutely the truth, too. I got an email from this guy, and he says, I want you to play at our wedding. I said, well, I sent the fee thinking he wouldn't do it. He says, that's no problem. And then I said, I better find out where it is. He says, I live in Hollister, which is up by, like, San Jose, Northern California. I wrote back, I said, well, I said, we're happy to do it, but we would need the performance fee plus transportation plus housing because we have to play at 11 o'clock on the 4th of July next year. He says, no problem. Just tell me how much. I'll pay it. I don't care. So now he's already, you don't even know this, he's requesting music for the ceremony now. So it's going to get real interesting. But there it is. We also opened the produce section at Ralph's Supermarket right here on Del Amo about 22 years ago, too. So. Go figure. Oh, yeah. So this is just a real beautiful instrumental of an old song that predates the American Civil War. Again, Irish in origin. This is about a fella like so many guys felt the same way when they were far from home and they were missing that someone special. And this is a really clever instrumental arrangement of The Girl I Left Behind Me. And if you listen, you'll even hear the bagpipes. So when we moved on to Charleston, and we weren't too sure how well we'd be accepted walking around the city in the blue jackets, as you might imagine, we had very little trouble. Only one guy went to, it's the Hundley, which is the Civil War era submarine that's there, and he rushed over after our performance on the Yorktown, and he was in uniform and all that stuff, and he went up, she said, I'd like two tickets to go in, and the woman, I don't know if she's putting him on or if she was serious, I think it's the latter, but she says, you make me sick. Anyway, that was all we got. That wasn't too bad. But we decided we wanted to do some music for our Southern brothers and sisters. And this next song is arguably the most popular song that was performed by every Confederate band. And if you've been to the South or if you've studied the South, you know that peanuts is one of the staples that grows there. There's peanuts every place. And they just love the weather and the humidity and all that stuff. And everybody loves peanuts. Problem down there is they boil them. And we finally tried it. Actually, James tried it and brought some. And it's kind of like a cross between peanut butter and oatmeal. It's pretty disgusting, actually. But we smiled and said, oh, yeah, that's really good. But anyway, this song is a real tribute to, again, our Southern brothers and sisters. This is a song that, for them, talked about something that was so important and a little way to poke some fun at their Northern brothers and sisters. We are honored and pleased to feature the song stylings of Mr. James Seamus Hendricks singing Goober Peas.
Sitting by the roadside on a summer's day, chatting with my messmates, passing time away, laying in the shadows underneath the trees. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas. Peas, 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 eating goober peas. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas. When a horseman passes, the soldiers have a rule to cry out their loudest,
hey, mister, here's your mule.
But another pleasure, enchantinger than these, is wearing out your grinders, eating goober peas.
Peas, 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 eating goober peas. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas.
Just before the battle, the general hears the row. He says the Yanks are coming, I hear the rifles now. He turns around in wonder, and what do you think he sees? The Georgia militia eating goober peas.
Peas, 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 eating goober peas. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas.
I think this song has lasted almost long enough. The subject's interesting, but the rhymes are mighty rough. I wish the war was over and free with flags and frees. We'll spread our lives and sweetheart and gobble goober peas.
Peas, 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 eating goober peas. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas. Peas, 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 eating goober peas. Goodness, how delicious, eating goober peas.
Thank you all.
We'll get that one of these days. This next song is, again, several traditions. The Civil War, of course, being fought in our own country amongst our own families sometimes, it would not be uncommon for maybe the Confederacy to be in Long Beach and the Union to be all the way up in Lakewood, like maybe even a couple miles apart. And because of that, it was not uncommon for commanding officers to actually live in the proximity of where the battle was going. So when it came time to entertain their troops, they oftentimes, if they had a daughter who could come and recite poetry and dance, Shannon, where are you? I saw you. Or if they had someone in the family who could sing or in some way perform or even for a few moments entertain the troops, they expected the bandmaster to write an arrangement that would feature one of the young ladies, because that's what the guys really wanted to see more than anything else. No different then than now. So this next song is also another tradition, which is before electronic media, sometimes I think that would be a blessing right now, but before that, news traveled very slowly. Print media was very slow, newspapers were not at all common, there was no radio or internet or anything else. Sometimes the fastest way for news to travel from place to place was through song lyrics, because people would sing a song and then go on to the next place, and Marching Through Georgia talked about what the Union had done. And this next song is about an event that took place that starts off to look like one thing, but ends up being something very, very different. And it's also the story of an infatuated young woman who thinks she's in love with the perfect man. And as she sings about him, she begins to realize that maybe he's not quite who she thinks. And the band is disgusted because they don't want to hear about it. So we're going to feature Vicki Gordon one more time singing The Buckskin Bag of Gold.
Last night I met him on a train, a man with lovely eyes, and he gave me such a searching glance, a sweetly charmed surprise. I knew 'twas he the lady meant, who once my fortune told. By his jet black eyes, his grand mustache, and his buckskin bag of gold. Yes, yes, he is the one who does my fortune hold. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. Tall, slim, quick as a flash, and 22 years old. His jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. The ever saw. Oh, how I love him now. And if I could live a thousand years, no other, here's my vow. Like Judas, no, like Jupiter. He is so brave and bold. With his jet black eyes, his grand mustache, and his buckskin bag of gold. Yes, yes, he is the one who does my fortune hold. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. Tall, slim, quick as a flash, and 22 years old. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. Sweet boy, bring me the morning call. Perchance I'll find his name. At the Grand Motel he must have stayed. I wonder why he came. He must have charmed those lumpkin girls, so haughty, proud, and cold. With his jet black eyes, his grand mustache, and his buckskin bag of gold. Yes, yes, he is the one who does my fortune hold. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. He's tall, thin, quick as a flash, and 22 years old. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. How can I seek a name unknown? Oh, tell me where he went. What is this? I read, why Papa's bank was robbed of every cent. The thief, it seemed, left town last night. My, my, I should have known. He had jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. Yes, yes, he is the one who does my fortune hold. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold. Tall, slim, quick as a flash, and 22 years old. He has jet black eyes, a grand mustache, and a buckskin bag of gold.
Your morning news brought to you by, yes, that's very cool. That was well done. Thank you. Let's do a, oh, thank you, Mr. Fred. So in 23 years, it's remarkable how stable this group has been. We've only had about a half a dozen or so changes. We have a kind of a running gag in the band that the only way to get out of the band is to pass on to that big band in the sky. And unfortunately, we've had three guys do that since we've started 23 years ago. Yeah, it paid the same. Yeah, exactly right. And we have one guy who's setting a precedent this evening, and he's leaving us. And he's been with the band for 17 years. He's moving to Portland, Oregon. And this is one of my favorite human beings on planet Earth. David Linson is not only a wonderful musician, he's as loyal and predictable as the sunrise. He's a sweet, honest man and a human being, and he married Sheila, which made all of us so happy too. So I got to sing at the I know she's right there, I see her. So that's Sheila waving over there, and she's smiling because she and David just got married a couple years ago. I was actually honored enough to get to sing at their wedding. So this is really a family affair up here, and when one of us leaves, it's not with any simple or light thing. So Mr. Linson, if you'd come forward, sir. So there's a song we do called Kazooty, Kazooty Co Whirl. And at the end, everybody yells Kazooty. Well, Dave yells Kazooty at the end of everything, including Amazing Grace and the Lord's Prayer and God knows what else. He always screams, Kazooty! And that's the way it goes. So this is the Kazooty Award. It is conferred upon Trooper David Linson for 17 years of service to the band of the California Battalion presented this 21st day of July, 2014, G.T. Scott commanding. David? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hurrah! Hip hip! Hurrah! Hip hip! Hurrah! Thank you, David. We'll see you in Portland. And now, sitting in his premiere, we hope, first of a whole bunch of performances, and he's reading the other alto horn part because the other alto horn guy is in Wisconsin or someplace. God only knows. Oklahoma, that's even worse. Why would you go to Oklahoma on purpose in July? Wow. Anyway, Mr. Christian Siqueiros is sitting in and just doing an amazing job. And thank you, thank you, thank you. So this is another song. Everybody said, you know, when the war started, the bands played military music, marching music, change of command ceremony music. And very quickly, the commanding officer said, forget that stuff. We need you to entertain. We really need you to brighten these guys' spirits, even if it's just for a moment. And it was so important that the guys in the bands come up with ways to entertain and do fun things. So this song is one of those. This is a silly little song called I Left My Love.
I left my love sleeping in her bed. I turned my back on my true love when fighting Johnny Red. I left my love a letter in the holler of a tree. I told her she could find me in the U.S. cavalry. Hi ho, down they go, there's no such thing as cat. We'll ride right down to Richmond Town for Ulysses Simpson Brand. Hi ho, down they go, there's no such thing as cat. We'll ride right down to Richmond Town for Ulysses Simpson Brand. Hi-ho, down they go, there's no such thing as cat. We'll ride right down to Richmond Town for Ulysses Simpson Grant. Hi-ho, down they go, there's no such thing as cat. We'll ride right down to Richmond Town for Ulysses Simpson Grant. For Ulysses Simpson Grant. For Ulysses Simpson.
In 1855, a young Southern musician, actually before I do this real quick, there's a couple people that I do want to thank. Most people don't understand that public universities, colleges, and institutions have elected boards of trustees that manage all of the work that goes on. And it's kind of an invisible job sometimes, it's kind of a thankless job sometimes, but we're honored tonight to have a member of the Board of Trustees from Long Beach City College present tonight, Mr. Doug Otto. Doug, thank you so much for coming. And the newest member of the Board of Trustees at Long Beach City College, longtime president of the foundation, Dr. Virginia Baxter. Congratulations, Jenny. And also thank the Board of Trustees of the Foundation. The Foundation raises millions of dollars for this college every year, and it's through their work and effort and continued support of our college. So to all of the board members of the Foundation, thank you for being here with us tonight as well. Thank you for everything you do. I know it's getting dark, so we're going to just kind of scoot to the end here. In 1855, a young Southern musician by the name of William Steff from South Carolina wrote a tune for the local firemen to sing as they whiled away their time in the firehouse in Richmond, Virginia. The song quickly became popular as a camp meeting song with its traditional glory hallelujah refrain, and it was soon being sung around the country, but with a variety of lyrics, as was the frequent tradition of the time. Now, early in the American Civil War, the Union troops began singing the lyrics, John Brown's body lies a-moldering in the grave, their version of lyrics set to Steff's already famous melody. In December of 1861, Julia Ward Howe, an activist in the anti-slavery movement, rode through the Union Army camps along the Potomac as a guest of President Lincoln. Now, being a church-going, conservative young woman, she was rather offended as she heard the body and somewhat crass language being spoken by the men. But she was even more dismayed when she heard the soldiers singing the Steff tune with the derogatory words about the death of John Brown, an abolitionist who'd been hanged. Now, ironically, the John Brown that the soldiers sang about was not the same fellow that Ms. Howe presumed that it was. This poor unfortunate fellow, actually had no connection to the abolitionist movement at all. But this gross misunderstanding would ultimately inspire one of our nation's most beloved songs. A clergyman at one of the camps, aware that Howe occasionally wrote poetry, suggested that she craft new verses that were more appropriate to the Civil War effort. She returned to the Hotel Willard that evening with the melody still on her mind. She was restless and couldn't sleep, and the tune, in her words, haunted her. When she awoke the next morning in the gray of the early dawn, she was astonished to find that the wished-for lines had arranged themselves in her mind. Still in her nightclothes, she got out of bed, crossed the darkened room, and quickly scrawled the new lyrics for Steff's melody that would soon become known as the Battle Hymn of the Republic. Soon afterwards, she submitted the poem to the Atlantic Monthly, which accepted it and paid her the princely fee of $4. The verses appeared on the first page of the February 1862 issue and quickly caught on as the rallying anthem of the North and the Union troops. The Battle Hymn of the Republic has buoyed Americans in conflict since it was first introduced. Howe's words would later inspire American soldiers during World War I, World War II, Korea, and Vietnam. It also became an anthem that was frequently sung by civil rights activists during the 60s and 70s. Today, this beloved song can be found in church hymnals of virtually every denomination. For many, the singing of this hymn, which enjoins Americans to crush the serpent and to even be willing to die to make men free, signals America's willingness to respond to adversity. Ladies and gentlemen, we hope you enjoy this Randall Silver setting of Julia Ward Howe's Battle Hymn of the Republic. Thank you.
the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible Swiss sword. His troop is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. I have seen him in the watchfires of 100 circling camps. They have built in him an altar in the evening dews and damps. I can read his righteous sentence by the dim and flaring mass. His day is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching.
So we're going to leave you with the signature song of the band of the California Battalion. There's one more person I would like to really acknowledge and congratulate. Rich Snyder is back there playing on snare drum, and you would think that that's not particularly remarkable. But we got a text from him last Monday night saying that he and his wife and son were headed off to Long Beach Memorial, and he was diagnosed with a 4-inch mass in his brain behind his eye. And that's a scary thing. And to go through all of that and to have the surgery and to sit and wait and to hope everything worked out. The good news is, the incredible news is that it was not cancerous. They did remove it, and he came home today. So Rich is back there playing. So geez, Sheldon says the bad news is he's still a drummer, though. Yeah, it's, you know, sorry. Jeez, that hurts. Y'all know the difference between a drummer and a large pizza? A large pizza will actually feed a family of four. So that's just in case you need to. So thank you all for being here. This is Long Beach is such a wonderful community, and there's such a great tradition of this. Oh, thank you. One more thing. This is a good point. Jennifer's over there waving. We actually produced a DVD of the band. These are live performances from the battlefield at Gettysburg, from the National Civil War Museum in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And it's some really great stuff. It's video and audio of the band. It's great audio. There's all kinds of fun stuff on it. And I know people have been bugging us, when are you going to get a CD? When are you going to get a CD? This is a DVD. So please don't put it in your CD player. It won't work. I promise. It won't work, but it's very cool DVD stuff. So if you have a DVD player, you could see Jennifer, beautiful woman there in the green stuff, and she has them there for sale. And with that, we're going to leave you with the barbershop. No,
Fireman's Polka.
Fireman's Polka. There's two versions to this song. The first version is in the beginning of the song, it's about firemen asleep in the firehouse. When suddenly the alarm sounds and they rush across the room and they slide down the pole and they hook up the horses and they fire up the boiler and they rush across town and they pump up the pressure and they put the water in the building and they save everything, much to the great acclaim of everyone in their town. Now our version, and this is what we're sticking to, truth be known, all of these firemen and fire babe before the war were all members of the same brigade and lived in the same firehouse. And they enjoyed great esteem in their community until that fateful night when their firehouse burned to the ground. And we saved the bell from the firehouse, we saved that and we've taken it everywhere that we go. So in the beginning of the song, we mourn our failure at our craft, our inability to protect even our own house. But in the end, how the men and women of California will rise to the occasion. So thank you all for being here. I hope you have a wonderful, great summer. Lots of music going on here. Thank goodness the budget's getting better, and we're going to start to see a lot more events like these come back. Give it a little time. We need it. We definitely need it. We all need music and art to make our lives better. So thanks for being here and sharing with us. This is the Fireman's Polka.
Thank you.
in the morning.
Gonna shoot the captain.
Early in the morning.
Gonna shoot the captain.
Early in the morning, and I hope I'm in the band. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me, and I hope I'm in the band.
Gonna chase some hoop skirts.
Early in the morning.
Gonna chase some hoop skirts.
Early in the morning.
Gonna chase some hoop skirts.
Early in the morning, and I hope I'm in the band. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me, and I hope I'm in the band.
Gonna smoke some burley.
Early in the morning.
Gonna smoke some burley.
Early in the morning.
Gonna smoke some burley.
Early in the morning, and I hope I'm in the band. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me, and I hope I'm in the band.
Good night, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. Have a safe ride home. Good night. Again, if you'd like DVDs, Jennifer will be up here.